Okay, so yes, those who are just joining in, or I guess if you're watching this in the future, that's weird. Anyway, this is Last Half of Darkness Part 2. We played the first one.
We did.
And I guess I should introduce you, Sarah, Pushing Up Roses. You're here.
You didn't do that before.
I'm doing it this time.
I think people may have called you out. They're just like, you never introduced that person. And I'm like,
Well, here you are, and you play games, which is cool.
I've been known to play a few games. Just a couple.
A few. Adventure games, like the one we're playing here. And so, yeah, this is also, what is it? This came out in 1991, maybe? I don't know. I think the first one came out in, it was a couple years afterward.
1992. Like it says on 92? It says on the screen.
Oh. Oh, copyrighted 1992. Well, tag on it. I got a cheat sheet right in front of me.
Good job.
All right. So yeah, let's go ahead and we'll start this up.
Let's do it. So should we tell them what the game developer told us?
Yeah, sure. Why not? The developer of this got in touch with me and you eventually on through YouTube, William Fisher III. Saying that he was surprised anyone was still playing his game, much less enjoying it so much, which was awesome. So, got in contact about it. And then he had a little bit of a warning saying 2 and 3 maybe might not be as good. But I don't know. I still have hope. This is cool. I like this game.
I do, too. So I do, too.
We'll see.
I'm glad he kind of gave us the warning.
Yeah, me too. But at the same time, I still have hopes. So
it still looks really quite nice. It looks like they just kind of continued from the last one.
What happened at the end of the first one? Okay, so we got into a room, right? And then there was a chick and we brought her back to life or something.
Yes. There's something we should probably explain though.
Yeah.
And that would be the developer, when he contacted us, he said that in the beginning of the game, in the description, you're supposed to see the light on in the attic. And so when you start that game, you're supposed to go to the attic a lot sooner than we did and find her alive. And then later, you hear her scream. I think we actually didn't notice it. It probably did happen, but we didn't
notice it. We were looking at the guy with the big axe, and then there was a scream, and so we totally lost a track of what was going on.
Well, I mean, that's not my fault.
It's not anybody's fault.
We were dealing with a dude with an axe, preoccupied.
Exactly.
So basically, yeah, what happened last is we ran into that woman, we brought her back to life, and that's where we're doing now. I'm going to start narrating. The surroundings around you are unfamiliar, as the last thing you remember is a beautiful girl taking you through a stone doorway into darkness. You must have blacked out because somehow you ended up here, which looks surprisingly like the last house we were in.
It does. It's got the same blue everything, which is cool because blue. And
because blue.
Well, you know, I was wondering what happened to the girl, because obviously you were running away from something with the girl that we woke up, and she's gone now, so
well,
I guess we'll figure it out.
My guess is we probably made a pass at her, and she panicked. A plant rests on the cabinet. What is that, Buzzberry? The sim plant?
Could be Bumble Leaf.
This doorway seems to be boarded up for some unknown reason.
Yes, indeed.
Wait a minute!
What?
Where's our inventory?
It's all gone.
Yeah,
I know. It's gone. And you can't load your previous game from the previous game. So, and I tried, and it did nothing.
I'm upset.
We got new inventory. Well, look, we have a lit torch. That's good. We didn't have a torch last time at all.
Where's our red shit?
It's all gone. And our money's gone.
We had money.
Ah!
We had so much money.
Ugh. Well.
Maybe the woman took all of our stuff.
Oh, we ran into this one lady in this haunted house. She turns out to be a gold digger. Dang it. Took it all and left.
She took our watering can.
It had water in it, too.
Ugh. There's a book inside this bookcase.
Well, I suppose we should probably take it.
Take it.
Which would be... Aha!
Oh, so shortcut keys.
Heck yeah. I'm trying to use them. But it's so easy to click. Anyway, I'm going to open the book. Holy crap.
What?
Look at, I tried to open the book. That's a lot of pages.
Oh, Jesus. Yeah, it's kind of lagging on my end. To which page would you like to open the book? 1 through 500. All right, let's do just 256. Do it. It's going to be great.
So I don't know if you heard that, but that was a creepy sound. You probably don't have sound on yours.
No, page 256 of this book contains scribbles unfamiliar to you.
Don't tell me we have to... Oh my goodness, let's see what page one is. All right.
We're not going through 500 pages of this book.
That's the rest of the stream, all 500 pages.
The words Frank's book are written on page one. Oh, it's Frank's. Of course.
Who else's book would it be?
We should probably give it back.
It's probably just going to be a lot of scribbles. So far, it's like scribbles. Like... Okay, the sound is still doing things, which is quite creepy, actually. I don't like that at all.
Oh, I don't hear it, so I guess I'm in the...
It's just like, you know, it's one of those. It's. I think I should close the book because it is making noise. All right, let's see what else we have in here. We have a plant, a wall. I guess we can't take the plant. Nope.
Okay, that's too bad because the plant actually kind of stands out.
It does. It's just, it's a wonderful green in this blueness.
Let's set the boards on fire with our torch.
Oh, totally.
Let's burn this place down.
Hey, look. You attempt to burn the object, but no.
No. So I wonder if we can burn objects. Well, you know what? I think we should just climb out the window. Let's just do it. I'm sure that's where she went.
I'm not sure. Okay. So, yeah, it's not showing up on our little exit map, so I guess not.
Oh.
Let's see. Lightning illuminates the sky. Well, that's obvious. I guess we got to go down this... where are we? This is like an attic or something.
Maybe we're in the attic of the house of our late aunt's house.
It's possible.
You cannot use the go command outside of the view screen or exit box.
Whatever, then. Okay, we'll do that.
Wow, look. Colors.
Sort of.
Colors that are not blue. You are located below the house in a dungeon-like corridor where there is a wood ladder leading up into darkness. It is made from oak, but doesn't look too sturdy.
Well, we got down it just fine, so...
Yeah, but what if it's one of those puzzles where you can only go up and down the ladder, like, so many times? It's not that high off the ground. It's not like you can die by falling, right?
I guess not. I just did like 3 or 4 times, so it's okay.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so there's nothing here. Ooh, we're in a dungeon or something.
Oh, I hope this isn't a maze.
You know, I bet it is. Just because we don't want it to be. I'm gonna go left because this room is red and there's color. Oh, my.
Oh, okay. This room is filled with lit candles which illuminate the walls with a glow of red. Large coffins decor this room as horror as cobwebs hang from the ceiling. Something tells your senses this might not be the best place for you to go snooping.
Yeah, probably
not. Those
are
cobwebs? They look like curtains.
Yeah, somebody just tore them up. I don't know, man. These are really strong spiders. Like, they have spinners of steel or something.
Sweet. We should get out of here.
We should investigate things. Look, there's lit candles and...
Open it.
Open the closed coffin.
Wait a minute. Should we say... We didn't save our game.
Nope.
The coffin has been opened, revealing a strange creature inside.
We are probably dead. Let's see.
We are so dead. If we only had our axe.
I know, right? We don't have anything. I guess we can't...
Torch it.
Yeah. Nope. Nothing catches fire.
Huh.
Hmm.
Let's give him our book. He's probably bored. He's been in that coffin for a while. Some good rating would do him well.
Nope.
Hmm.
I want to know what that is, but we can't do anything to it. That's terrible.
Can we talk to it?
No, because remember, like, you have to do something for the talking to even work.
Oh, okay.
You get them to come up on the... If they're the only thing shown on the screen, I think, is when the talking seemed to work. Hmm. Let's just get out of here.
I guess we could just leave. Yeah, let's just leave. The passage ends directly in front of you and splits into two directions, leading both left and right. You can notice a faint sound behind the wall. It sounds as if somebody is calling out for help.
Yeah, there are definitely sounds, all right, and they're painful. They hurt.
Oh, no.
It's like that terrible digitized PC speaker noise. It's really bad.
Oh, God.
Yeah, so left or right? There's going to be something important here.
I don't know. Don't put this pressure on me. Left.
Let's go right then. No, let's go left. We went left. There's a thing.
This dungeon passage travels... I don't know. You click too soon. Bah. Nah. It looks like a wooden stake. We need that. Take that.
We probably do.
Put that in your pants.
We got them in the pants. So that is a wooden stake. Looks very sharp.
It probably is quite sharp.
I bet.
Let's go stab the creature with it. I don't know why. He's minding his own business, but definitely we should stab him.
All right. Save the game. This is so totally a maze. Dang it.
No way.
Ah, crap. Hey. Whoa.
Oh, hi. It's the caretaker's dog holding the caretaker's head. The head speaks. I am but a head, but the other three know a taste of a ring will let you go.
What? Man, this is getting weird.
Well, I have a book.
Okay. Well, that's good.
We don't have a ring.
No. Why is the head speaking is what I'm wondering.
It's alive.
But why? How? This makes no sense. The other one at least followed a little bit of logic other than ghosts and creepy weird girls and stuff. But talking heads?
Let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Ahead. Ah, crap.
Did you die?
Yep. I think so.
Oh, you died. The dog quickly drops the head and starts towards you with a strange look of revenge in its eyes. He begins to tear your leg off as you try to escape, but it's no use. Nice shoes, though.
That is a fantastic shoe. It's been put together with staples or something. Very tiny nails.
I like how his teeth are just triangles.
Yes.
Nom, 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 nom.
Well, I guess that's that.
Well, that's the end of the stream. Thank you, and good night.
Let's not do that again. Let's see, we went...
But how do you know where to go now?
Well, okay, so this is the way we went, and we'll... Ugh, stupid noise. That's so bad. Let me turn that down. It's really, really awful. And you may be thankful that you can't hear it, but I'm sure the stream can.
I can't wait to actually watch it and see what it is.
Yeah.
Although the stream is doing a great job of making it come to life for me.
Okay, let's go right.
Hey, a dude. Hey, dude. Santa. Oh, it's a beggar. The beggar sits, holding out a tin can. Here, have this book.
You're just like a library here. Look, have these books, everyone. Just books.
I just want people to learn.
Oh, he refused.
He refused our gift?
Yep.
What a D-bag. Torch him.
Okay. No, he doesn't want anything. Well, he's
Sir,
holding...
I was not offering you the torch. I wanted to torch you.
I know. Maybe you can take his little tin can of whatever. Who
well,
begs
mean.
In a dungeon? Who? Who are you going to beg from?
The dog? The head?
The dog. Maybe this is just a weird dream sequence because this makes zero sense so far.
Well, let's talk to him. Hi. Fool! Go away! Mutters the old man. I talk to only those who know my name.
Ah, crap. Well, we don't know. Maybe it's Frank.
It's Frank's book.
Yeah.
Say it like, hi, Frank. Hello, my friend. Open my book to page 237.
It's like a choose your own adventure book all of a sudden. Great. Hey, cool.
Hey, a dollar. There's a dollar on this page and a riddle which reads, "This page, once found, should long be forgotten. When opened again, the dollar is rotten."
Okay. That's a thing.
Give him the dollar. Put it in his tin can. Like, is that what we want to do?
I don't know. I'm trying to do something with the dollar on the book. I can look at it. It says it reveals some money.
Huh.
Maybe take... No, it's already in the inventory. I already have it. Well, yeah, but I'm trying to do things.
But you can't take it off of the book.
I don't seem to be able... Maybe I'll just take the book and... No, you will need it more than... Well, Yeah, this is curious.
All right, well, maybe we're just done with that part.
It's possible.
Maybe, yeah, we probably just needed the hint, and now that's that. Okay. This passage reveals a large doorway up ahead. It appears to be leading into darkness with a lit torch at its entryway. Oh, man. You know, at least it's not like Shadowgate, where you have to... you have to keep, like, lighting your torches.
Oh, yeah, that would be terrible.
Be a lot worse. It could be a lot worse.
Of course, we don't know that yet, but, you know, it's probable that we don't have to.
Watch, I just jinxed it. It's all over now.
We can go down in the hole. I'm going to go in the hole.
This creepy dungeon places you even farther down into darkness as the light from above faintly shines your path into the unknown. That's blue. There are three doorways here, along with a small set of bones. One doorway clearly shows a view of a large glass skull, which sits on an oak display box. Oh, that poor guy.
I know, man.
So why did he die, but that beggar is still alive?
Why anything, right? I don't know. This is a really confusing place.
Why anything, I know.
This guy didn't get very far. No kidding. Let's see if we can take his hand.
Part of a hand chained to him. Well, that's very nice of you to want to take his hand in his time of need, but I think he's dead.
Yeah, I don't think a handhold will do much at this point. Okay, wait, I just went backwards. Okay,
you want to take that skull?
Yeah, I do. Kind of a lot.
What just happened? Where are you? This room is filled with dust and odors from centuries ago. The far wall is decored by a strange painting of ghouls and ghosts. A light from above shines through a small hole in a large blue glass skull located in the center of this room. That is the worst painting.
It's pretty bad.
Somewhat damaged picture. It's pretty bad. It's pretty bad composition. I give it a D.
Yeah. I don't even know what's on it. Like, what is it supposed to be?
Ghouls and ghosts.
Yeah, but that looks like no ghouls ghoul or ghosts. Ghost. It's more like tapeworms and leftover vegetables or something. Oh, well.
Those are scary, too, if we had to be honest.
Yeah, they are.
This magnificent glass skull looks as if it might be worth millions, but I wouldn't suggest taking it. Let's take it!
Dang straight, we're going to take it.
Oh, saving your game. Are you scared?
Absolutely, this is Last Half of Darkness. Ah, crap.
Ah, it's the leftover vegetable. Fool! Cries the ghost. I've got you now. And that he does, as the phantom tears your heart from your body, the sounds of horror echo throughout the sky.
I've got you now, and that he does.
Would you like to play again?
Yes. I think it's funny that the last death didn't let us want to know if we played, or want to know if we wanted to play again. This time it did. I guess... I don't know. It's like, yeah, you don't really care. If you die this early in the game, you probably don't want to play again. So, but this time it asked, so I'm glad. Nothing but dust.
Oh, but I really want the skull.
Yeah, I know.
It would look great on my desk.
Yeah, well, I'm not sure if this is the same hole or not. It looks a lot like it. Ah, crap.
It looks...
No!
What? What happened?
I accidentally ran into the dog again.
Oh, no.
Alrighty.
Oh, no. Okay, give him the dollar. Give him the dollar.
What, the dog?
Oh, no. Yeah.
I don't know how.
The head, the dollar. The head's got to eat.
What, the head wants a ring or something?
Yeah, the head wants a ring. Okay, you screwed up. That's your fault.
Yeah, that was just totally wrong. So let's check the other part of the dungeon. Oh, man. What the frick is that?
Oh, my God. Yeah, there is a very angry-looking swamp creature. And when we say swamp creature, what we really mean is a skeleton drenched in moss, standing in front of you with a large sword. He occasionally swings it about as if he was trying to show you his fencing skills. Well, that is very impressive, sir.
I am impressed by those skills, moss bones. So...
Tell him you're impressed. Speak to him.
Oh...
What are you doing? Why are you trying to stake him? He's trying to impress us, yo.
Oh. He doesn't care. Maybe he's just working out that arm. It's that forearm strength workout. I don't know. It's I guess we'll just go past him. Or I could hit him.
All right.
Oh, hitting him was a bad idea.
Clint. Look, his nose is running. Needless to say, the swamp-like creature was not abused by your efforts of destruction against him. He quickly slices your heart with one blow to the chest.
This
is... Would you like to play again?
This is proving to be a lot more deaths in a short amount of time than the first one, that's for sure.
Yes, it is.
Okay, I just went right past him, so...
There's a jail-like wall here, with a few of the bars bent from unknown circumstances. As look closer at the jail, you can notice a pair of eyes looking in your direction.
Is that what those are? Because, those are eyes. I guess
those are eyes.
I can see it now.
I blink that much. Almost
like,
I mean.
It almost looks like, yeah. It's like strobe light eyes, but whatever. It sounds like Cheshire cat teeth or something. But that works.
All right, let's do it. It's probably a friendly little puppy.
Do I have the... Well, yeah, I guess. Hmm.
Do you have the feeling that you're... Is that a question?
I don't know. Just ellipses after that, so... Well... Okay, well, let's just go in there with the eyes. There we go.
Let's do it. There's a large chest located in the back of this dark...
Sorry.
You cannot use the go command outside the view screen or exit box. Let's collect skulls. Ah, this room gives an eerie decor as old bones are piled in the corner as shadows are cast everywhere. Eerie ambience. Decor.
Yes. Okay, nothing happens there. Hit the bones, does nothing. Take the bones, does nothing. Okay.
Torch it.
What is this thing? We got a pirate chest.
What? Pirates?
I don't know.
Why?
What the crap?
What was that? Oh. Oh. This creature is quite nasty when it's not sleeping as it begins to rip the meat from your head with each strike. I like how it just calls it a creature, because I have no idea what that is.
Yeah, that resembles basically nothing, so...
It's a dog snake.
It's a creature, okay.
Let's name it. I'm going to name it Teddy.
Teddy.
Teddy. Teddy the dog snake.
That works for me. Okay. Because I'm 100% at a loss here now, because as far as I know, we've gone everywhere. Almost.
Maybe we have to go back to the red room. I have a feeling that we're definitely missing...
I found a place.
Okay. I was just going to say I have a feeling we're missing some... what the fuck is that? This particular dungeon room reveals both an old-time rocking chair and a shelf on the far wall. The shelf seems to contain a few odd and old-looking rare books, but don't mind the corpse in the rocking chair or anything. Let's not touch on that.
It doesn't mention that whatsoever, and that is disturbing.
I think she's trying to talk to us.
Yeah, let's hope.
This is a very scary woman sitting in your aunt's old rocking chair. I hope it's not your aunt. Why do we have a rocking chair in the dungeon? Is this where she does her knitting?
I am... yeah, man, because she had to knit that giant rug somewhere. So, it's possible.
What was that hint that was in the book again? I forgot.
Oh, crap, me too.
I mean,
what was it? 237?
Yeah.
Oh, what a bunch of lies.
Oh, no.
And now the money's gone.
What?
Yeah, the money's gone now.
Oh, no.
It was 237, though, right?
Yes, I think so.
It says...
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Crap.
What did you do?
I don't know. This is such a weird...
It's back!
Weird version of the game.
It's back!
Yeah, it is. It's reloaded. That's okay. So oh, you go reloaded. Back in here and...
I thought it was magic.
No, it's not quite. It's just pressing F10.
Damn it.
Oh, crap.
She just wants to be friends. As you reach toward the shelf, the woman gets up.
And, I hate this game.
Oh, that's a nosebleed. You are a fool to steal from me, cries the mysterious ghost woman. She appears to not take kindly to thieves as she slowly begins to dismember your body limb from limb.
What in the world? Like, this is seriously getting on my nerves. There's so many quick deaths that are so cheap.
Does anybody else have the taste for ketchup? No?
Ew. No.
Let's, can we possibly try to stake her?
Yeah, maybe.
I mean, we have this stake. I wanted to do what I wanted to do at first, which is go back to the red room and stake the creature. Which you never did, Clint.
I didn't?
No, you never did. We've only been in that red room once. So I think we should go back to the red room and stake the creature that's in the coffin. It's probably a vampire.
Okay, let's try that.
I have good ideas, Clint.
I don't
sometimes
deny that whatsoever. Okay, we're in the red room. And...
The red room is my favorite. There you go. Why didn't you do that when I first suggested it?
I didn't. I thought that I did, but I apparently didn't.
You staked him.
So.
He falls to the ground, revealing a small flute.
Small flute. We got it. It's flute.
We're winning.
It's a purple flute.
Cool. Now, who can we play a lovely tune? Maybe to the woman?
Maybe the snake thing.
The snake dog? Teddy?
Yeah, Teddy the snake dog. Actually, wait, is there something else on the creature? No, that's the snake. Now it says it's a dead vampire.
I'm surprised it didn't try to attack us when we first...
Yeah, this is an intriguing... not following of its own rules necessarily, but that's okay. Whatever. All right,
let's go charm Teddy.
Teddy, we coming for you, buddy.
I love Teddy. He's my friend. He's my pal Bert.
Teddy,
I don't wanna
he's
kill
a cool
him.
Guy.
I don't want to kill him.
All right. it doesn't appear that I had a chance, because you open it up and it's instantaneous death.
Well, perhaps don't open it. Just use the flute on the chest itself.
Use the flute.
Yeah.
Yeah, true.
Teddy! Aww.
Guess not.
No, really?
Doesn't look like.
Is there a way that we can simply play the flute?
Also, I was trying to, like operate it, and it didn't do anything.
Maybe it's not for Teddy, then. Maybe it's something, maybe it is for the woman. We can play it for the woman. So if it doesn't work on the girl, go find somebody else. Okay, so it didn't work on her. Let's go find someone else. Like the moss guy.
Moss man? Nope.
Nope. Okay. Let's just,
There was something weird that happened when we took the skull. It was a ghoul, though.
I don't think it's a ghoul.
Okay, well, if anything, in the skull room, here's an entrance, or an exit, sort of. So behind us here now, I think, is the dog. So which means if we go forward, I don't remember if I saved it. I honestly don't. So, okay. Yes. Overwrite, you freaking... Okay, there we go. Uh-huh, yes, so we can continue in this dungeon, and we have found something.
Okay, give him the flute. Oh, it's like a Frankenstein monster.
Something.
There's a strange fellow here carrying a large axe. He looks as if he's give him the flute. That's all we have to work with, so let's
The flute, the money, and the torch, I mean... Oh, it distracted him. See, there we go. What happened
That's
to his axe?
That's the worst flute playing I've ever heard in my life.
Must
you
be pretty bad.
You distract the creature.
Hmm.
I just wanted a friend.
Oh, I want his axe, and it's gone.
Oh, no. I think he's just blocking your path. I think that's all. This passage reveals a dark doorway up ahead. It appears to be leading into darkness with a lit torch at its entryway.
Yeah, I think there's more grammatical errors in this one. That's awesome. Okay.
Ooh, a key. Or I think it's a key.
Looks like a key.
Yeah. Grab that.
Yeah.
The dungeon passage ends giving... Oh, okay. All right, cool. Okay, good. I'm glad you figured that out, that we were missing a room.
Yeah, it was that one little upper thing. So hopefully... Okay, it's blocking the path again. That's fine.
All right, just distract him with your flute.
I don't know if we needed to, but hey, it's done. So there we go. So... We haven't seen anything that's locked, though, right? Not yet.
I don't think so. Not yet.
Well...
So what can we use the key for?
Yeah, I mean, if we can go back down here, see if there's anything in here. Shelf-like cabinet, nothing but dust. I haven't seen anything even resembling it. Hey, maybe we can unlock this guy. I don't know what it would help, but...
I think he's beyond saving at this point.
I still want to help him out. The
I know you do.
It's just... it's a terrible fate. And he's just... His arm has got to be getting tired.
Did we try torching the dog...
No, I don't think we did.
Let's try that. If we run into the dog again with the head.
Yeah, we should just be torching everything.
I thought I was telling you to torch everything. That seems like something I would do.
Burn all the things. Yeah.
Burn
Sounds
it!
Sounds like your typical advice right there.
Thank you.
Just set it all on fire.
This is valuable advice I'm giving you.
It really is. So do we want to try to burn the dog?
Yeah,
hey,
pretty
what
much.
The crap?
What is this?
I don't know. We never went through here?
Apparently not.
Whatever.
All right, take it. The map.
Wait.
The map required. What?
What? Oh, you gotta be
is
kidding.
Is your printer ready?
No, it's not. I don't have a printer hooked into here. Oh my word. You can't be serious.
I think it is serious.
Oh no. Yes, ready. Print. You may resume playing. Well, this is...
What are we supposed to do now?
Well, that's somewhat... Yeah, I know. I need my dot matrix. I got it. I have one. I so could do it, but... Well, crap.
Yep.
Maybe there's a... Somebody has it. It's unlikely, but maybe it's been scanned somewhere online or listed somewhere. What in the world?
Yep. All right, torch him.
Torch this dog. How did we miss that last time? That's the same area. This is where the dog was.
Torch the dog and not the...
Oh, no! What happened?
Oh, God. It's all going downhill.
Oh.
Oh, no.
Oh, this is terrible. You just feel around for the exits and the... Oh, that's ridiculous. Okay, maybe now we can put the... We were saying that the torch didn't go out earlier. And of course it goes out, doesn't it?
Should we,
I relit the torch at work.
Okay,
that's good, that's good.
Okay, good. Now, let's find the dog again and torch the dog.
Oh. Wait
a
second.
If you can find the dog. Sure, printer ready. Oh, this game. It's trolling us.
What the?
The developer didn't warn us about that, did he?
No, he did not.
He did not.
Thanks for nothing, sir. I'm so confused. Where am I going?
I don't know where you're... Where's the dog? Is the dog gone?
This doesn't seem to be making any logical sense whatsoever. I'm clicking different areas.
Yeah?
And it's... It's going different places.
Did you break this game?
I don't know.
Look at your map!
Okay, great. Let me just reload it. I don't even know. Okay.
Oh,
so,
Lord. Is the game making noises?
Yeah, it's making noises. Making lots of noises.
Because the chat keeps on moaning and groaning. I can't help but think.
It's the noises.
What is that game doing?
And there's no other way to put it. It is straight up noise. It's really... Yeah.
I can't wait to hear it.
Oh, yeah, you can.
Oh, okay.
What is this? This is so confusing.
Go left. Oh, my goodness.
It's like it's changing. I'm serious. I'm pressing the...
I don't know.
Okay.
All right, let's think about this logically.
So I went right. Here's the old man.
Okay. Here's the old man.
He's always there. That's fine. So I go right, then go forward.
Okay.
Go left.
Okay.
And then, yeah, left again, then forward. And there's the green guy. So if I go back and then go right here, there's the green guy again.
Well, just you're not distracting him with the flute. Distract him with the flute. He's blocking you.
But okay. I'm just saying though. I go through here. I go through here, and here's a green guy, and
yeah.
Now I go back. This is a completely different area, completely different hallway, and here's another green guy. So I'm saying there have to be separate green guys.
Are you sure?
I'm positive.
Okay. I'll distract him anyway.
The flute does not work on this one.
Oh, torch him.
The torch has gone out. Well, why is it all of a sudden going out? Ever since
we
got that map.
But look, an unknown light source illuminates this corridor.
Really? I just went right past the green guy. Completely past him. This is a different one. So this is a different green guy. Maybe there's something weird here. Okay. Ah, I found another room.
Oh, good. Oh, good.
Okay. Something.
This room appears to be some sort.
It's a new word.
Of trap, revealing no doors or windows except for a small hole in the ceiling. It obviously challenges you to find a way out.
So obvious, you have to state it.
Torch it.
Yes, torch all the things. Oh, no! It went out again.
I did jinx it. Remember, we have to throw back to when I'm like, hey, at least it's, Teddy.
He came out of the skulls this time.
Teddy, you were hiding. Oh, hey, how's it going, buddy?
Freaking Teddy.
I'm sorry that I mentioned the torches in Shadowgate earlier, because I clearly jinxed this entire thing.
It's amazing how you did that, actually. Okay. Torch. See if we can...
Oh, I think it's cute that Teddy hides in random skulls. Oh, that Teddy.
That so Teddy.
That's so Teddy.
So that one we can just go right past.
I'm so amused.
Wait.
I love this game. I love this game.
Okay. Well, so this is the room. We were in the darkness last time, I think.
Okay.
Oh, no. This maze is really bad. Okay, let's go back to the same room if I can.
But I don't understand. We have a map now. Shouldn't that be helping us?
If we printed it out. Oh. Okay, so this one's distracted.
Okay, good.
I guess.
Could you find that room that you had just found with the skulls?
No. It's completely different this time. Like, I think I'm just wandering aimlessly now. And what?
A door
mysteriously appears. I think we're in hell. I have, like, seriously, this is not right. Things change, and this is like the Matrix is glitching out, and I'm seeing cats. Whoa, deja vu. And, you know, mouse dies. It's really bad.
I love it.
Okay.
I'm having fun, are you?
I kind of am, but at the same time, it makes no sense.
Well, you sound surly.
A little bit. It's friggin' torch. I'm just mad, man. The torch? What kind of weakness? Anyway, okay, let's try the key and the door. The door is now unlocked.
It is unlocked.
I suppose that means I'm going to go ahead and do that. Okay, let's open the door. Okay.
Okay.
Ah.
Ooh. This dark room contains a large wooden structure with three heads on it. Each head looks distinctively like the other without any particular characteristics about it. You can notice that the structure is slightly revealing an outside view.
Okay, I'm going to bring... Oh, hey, somebody sent me the map.
Oh, nice. But do we need it now, or are we doing okay?
I am not sure.
Okay.
But I'm going to leave it up here just in case.
Okay.
Because we are supposed to have it, obviously.
I miss Teddy.
Poor Teddy. He's been gone for too long.
All right.
Okay, so what are we doing in this room?
Torch it?
Sure. And run out of torch again? I don't think we should torch anything now.
Oh. I'm going to be very upset if we don't set something on fire very soon.
Didn't catch fire.
Huh. Is anything flammable in this game? Come on.
Well, there's bound to be, I mean.
Can we take the skull? I assume you already tried to take it. I guess just leave it for now.
Pretty much used all the things.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to go right.
Okay.
We got a thing. Another purple thing.
Oh, are those pliers there on the left?
Looks like. Let's see. Wooden crate with skull, unlit, something, another shelf ladder. Okay. Musty odors. Mmm. Smells like must.
I love must.
Whatever.
It's sexy smell.
Must?
What?
Fucking weird, man.
Yeah.
All right. We got some things. What do we got? bolt cutters.
Bolt Good. Cutters, yes. I need that.
Yeah.
I think the chat is questioning my Whatever, I do what I want.
Uh-huh. Oh, this is Ooh, creepy.
Oh. Oh, what is that? The attic is filled with an odor unfamiliar to your senses, unlike must. Their doorway to the right with a small sign beside its entrance, which warns minors to stay. There's so many grammatical errors in here. I will have a field
this one's
day.
So much worse than the first.
That it is entrance. Ah.
Just hold off. It's okay. There's been so many. It's so far. It's, well, we can't have minors.
Let's talk to our friend. I wonder if he knows Teddy. Do you know Teddy?
Hey, look.
The creature speaks as he points to a doorway. A game of 21 is played in that room. Bring back the ring.
Hmm. Well, that was helpful.
My precious.
Maybe we can play some friggin' blackjack. That would be sweet.
Oh.
Oh, give me some gambling. I would enjoy that. That would completely make up for all the terrible maze. Oh, okay. It looks like a sign. I like that.
Do you want to hit on the sign? Because then we would be throwing back to the first game. Like old times. Like old times.
Yes. I literally hit the sign this time, though. Bam, bam. Just beat that sign. No way.
Oh, whoa. Are we going to gamble? You have $30
so.
Left. Enter your bet. Oh, no. Okay.
$5.
That's pretty steep, dude. What are you doing?
Man, whatever. We okay?
No.
Yeah.
Oh, you're going to... I'm not involved with this. You're going to do this part.
Okay. Now, which hand am I looking at?
I don't know. I'm guessing
dealer hand is on the right. I would assume.
I would assume so. I would say hit.
Yeah, but we got like what, 15?
I thought those are sixes.
I think that's a six and a nine. The bottom one.
Oh,
is
it
a
is
nine.
A nine. I thought that was a
that
six.
That would help if it said.
Yeah, you're right.
It's a nine. Yeah, no, there's a nine. You can see the hearts too. Okay, so oh man, that's a tough. That's a terrible one.
That's bad, but I would hit. Just hit
All
me.
Right.
Hit me.
We bust.
Oh damn it!
Another $5. I don't know how much we need to win this ring. So oh, we definitely stand in this time.
Yeah, we're standing.
Ah, dealer bust. Oh yeah. We're back up to 30. Definitely standing again. Ooh, or we could go for the split since we. Hmm.
I don't want to split. I don't want to split. I'm not feeling it.
Ah, but I am. Okay, we'll stand. Okay, that's mm-hmm. that's good then.
Mm-hmm.
Good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Well, so I'm assuming we got to get rid of all his money.
Hit me.
It's totally the axe guy too. Ah, crap! One over.
Hit me.
Ooh. Oh, standing. Ah, crap.
Oh, crap.
No. What if we just go for broke?
No.
Heck yeah. So.
Oh, shit. Really?
Stand. Dealer
yes.
busts.
Yes, nice.
Yeah.
Nice job.
So we got $50 now.
All right.
He doesn't look like he's got much left. I don't see any money under that ring anymore.
Hit me.
So. Oh, no. Okay. S? No, that's not what I want. What the heck? Ah!
Redo from start? Whoa.
I don't want to do that. Okay, the game just glitched out, but whatever.
Phew.
Player gets blackjack. New deck. Yeah, game totally just glitched out, but... Graphics are all weird.
Hit me! Damn it.
Oh,
damn it.
What a puzzle, playing blackjack. That's cool.
That is not a puzzle.
Yeah, it kind of is. That's like in, what was it? One of those, it was a Ripper or something? There was one of those, it was like a game of chance in there involved, and it was weird. It was technically a puzzle. Sort of, kind of. Anyway.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
We busted.
Very nice. Come on, we got to get that ring.
Oh, we got this.
Mama needs a new monitor.
Oh, what crap? Friggin' pushes. Okay. No, not stand. Wrong button. No!
Oh,
well, you
no.
got blackjack anyway, so.
Oh, did
okay.
we win?
No,
oh, we didn't win.
We didn't win that one. We definitely. Player got blackjack.
I'm
okay.
never gambling with you.
It's probably a bad idea.
Yeah. Good.
Aha. Okay, so that's good. That's good. Now what? Give me the friggin' ring. 16.
Hit!
That's a bad idea. Maybe we have to bet like a...
Insurance?
Yeah, go ahead, because that is... Okay, that's fine. Yeah, good. Okay.
Can we put our flute up on the table?
Yeah, let's bet everything. I got a bolt cutter here, a book with some money in it, a useless map I can't print out. What do we have to bet to get that ring? What? Bet ring. Nope.
No.
I didn't do crap.
Maybe we just have to keep winning.
I guess. Oh. 15. Oh, no.
Ah.
New deck. What do you do?
The ring, look. The ring keeps... I don't know if that's a glitch or not, but it looks like it keeps coming forward.
I'm pretty sure it's just... Oh, hey, look.
Hey, what happened?
I don't know.
Okay.
It's weirdness.
The attic is filled with an odor unfamiliar. Okay, oh.
Yeah.
Oh, that looks not good. That looks demonic. Okay, run. We got the ring. Just run.
Oh, no. It's glitching out again. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to have to use the shortcuts now because it's all screwed up.
Oh, no.
Oh, it's terrible. Let me just, I'm going to quit and come back.
Okay.
Because I don't know what's going on with this thing. All right, so. Yeah, we got a ring. So that means we can take care of the dog now, right?
No. You give the ring. The ring
the
was
head.
The riddle.
For the head.
Oh right, for the head. That's right.
For the dog head. Yeah. So. Oh wait, what is this?
What is this? The gypsy in the room sits looking into her crystal ball. She quickly notices you and speaks, Madame de Maze Terizol. The room around her is filled with strange web curtains and sheets, obviously used to stimulate an eerie atmosphere.
Eerie atmosphere. Yay.
Look into my crystal ball.
Look at it. Into it. I will examine your crystal ball. Sitting there in front of... Oh, yeah, we know that. Nothing.
I don't suppose that we're supposed to give her the ring in turn for a glimpse into the crystal ball.
Maybe she wants the money that's not showing up in the book anymore.
We don't have
crap,
money. We have a ring
what?
Now.
Oh, that was what we used the money in blackjack? So it was $30. Okay, well, that's helpful.
I'm actually not okay. sure, but I mean, we could try.
There's no money in the book anymore, so I'm assuming.
Okay.
It's not there, so. Yeah. I guess we should speak.
Yeah, let's talk to her.
Oh, hey, look. Crystal ball is being crystals.
I see an island, yes. An island... called Ghost Island. You must go there. A boat will take you. Money, he asks, but give him none. Tell him to Maz, he will run. But first, you must present the ring to the wall of heads.
Which kind of sounds like outside this room.
I wonder,
that's a wall.
With the boat, with the money, is that like a reference to Charon? Like The boatman who takes you across the River Styx. That'd be cool. I'd be down with that. I like that lore.
I say let's roll with it because that makes it sound awesome. So, so do we give the ring to this wall of heads here? Or do we try the head on the dog head?
Those ghouls that were outside of the blackjack room, the ones that were seizuring, I think you should use the ring on those.
Well, that's
because
an idea.
Because the little guy who was there before suggested... Do you remember? I feel like he turned into those ghouls and we have to give him that ring.
So I gave it to him.
Okay, yeah. So, yeah, I definitely... I remember because he was, like, a little golem. Oh, what is this? The ghouls take the ring and examine it closely. They speak. The words outside have been marked on this ring. They give back the ring. There we go.
What the frick?
What
happened? It glitched out. Oh, it's covering up our inventory. Oh, jeez. Well, let's just remember that the bolt cutters are there and the...
the flute, yeah. I can remember okay. that. It's okay.
Okay, I'm pretty sure we need to use it on here. You've sprung a trap. Oh, look, we're down here
we're
again.
Down here.
Teddy's lair. Teddy number two.
Teddy!
Well, there he is.
Teddy!
Yeah, it's too bad. Can't do anything about that.
Okay.
Teddy is relentless. So, yeah. All right, so obviously we... But she said to, like, use it on a wall of skulls.
Read... use the ring on each skull.
Oh, gotcha.
So use it on each one individually.
That one worked.
There we go. Okay, the ring fits perfectly onto the head as it begins to speak. Where is the Forgotten Land? Only the Room of Ghouls know. Give them the ring and they will show. Obviously outside.
Yeah, man.
A strange force carries you outside. Located in the darkness of the forest, you come upon a very old bridge which provides a passage over the dangerous jagged rocks below.
We're finally somewhere out of that stupid dungeon. Yay.
Phew.
Okay, so we should cross a bridge.
Let's do it. But what about the head?
Ah,
it is Charon.
Speaking of,
it is.
Yeah.
That's him. A large hooded figure stands in a small boat up ahead. He appears to be waiting for a customer to take to Ghost Island, located in the distance.
25 cents. We don't need to give him any money, so...
We don't have to give him any money?
She said not to.
Tamaz, speak to him. Say Tamaz.
Oh, that's right. That's right. There we go. Ha ha.
The paradise is known as Ghost Island. Filled with tropical plants and beautiful palm trees, the beaches are a perfect vacation spot for ghosts, ghouls, and pirates.
Yes.
This sign looks as though it's been here a very long time.
Somehow I feel we're just starting. Because, like, I just do... let's go left. It's turning into Monkey Island. What is this?
If this paradise wasn't called Ghost Island, it could pass as a great vacation spot with beautiful palm trees, white sandy beaches, and even an extremely large ghost ship. Wow, this is becoming awesome.
And even an extremely large ghost ship. Yes, it's got it all. Ghost Island. Yeah. Let's go on the ship.
All right.
What a bad idea.
Hello. The wooden plank is heavily guarded by a strange fellow. He looks as if he would be best described as a ghost pirate. First mate, perhaps. There's a large pirate ship revealed with him, behind him with the sounds of the ocean in the distance.
Yeah.
Let's attack him with bolt cutters.
I'm gonna chop your parts off. Oh, nothing happened. Nope, that doesn't work.
The ring
doesn't work. Maybe the ring. Nope.
Let's talk to him, Tamaz. I don't know if that'll work.
Oh, wrong button. I don't think so. Hey, wait, what?
What?
It brought me back here.
Ooh, programmed
wrong.
Is
that a magic word? What if it's like a magic word?
It is a magic... I don't think that was supposed to happen. I think
maybe it is.
I don't think that's supposed to happen, dude.
Teleportation.
I think it knows that word now, and it'll always...
Look at that!
Yeah, that's just the way the game was programmed. It's always going to bring us back. It's not a glitch. That's just how it was programmed. All right, we got to figure...
Tavaz! Poof! We are here again. Isn't that great?
No, it's a programming problem.
Was there someone else or somewhere else to go with the ship? Oh, yeah, we can go to the right. Yeah, let's go to the right. Oh, hey, look. It's what's-her-face, maybe.
It's our lady friend. This path leads up to a very large and hot volcano where there is a small sacrifice area. It seems the natives on this island still use virgins to satisfy the volcano to avoid its eruption. First of all, who is this woman? Why was she in our aunt's attic? Our aunt who is dead? Who is this?
You know, why was anything in her aunt's house? That was just messed up. But, all right, I'll speak to Virgin Lady. Tamaz, no, actually, we'll probably we'll teleport back to the beach. Crap. Well, I guess
say
that's not
hi.
It.
Oh, let's give her the ring. I know it's really sudden, but I feel a commitment is worth it. So I would.
Hey,
I mean,
she's kind of. You got a captive audience here. You know, is she really going to say no?
I know.
May as well. Oh, crap. I don't want to save the game, but okay, go ahead since I clicked the wrong thing. What am I trying to do here? There it is. Here, have a ring, lady. Nope.
Darn.
She don't want it.
I thought we were supposed to put a ring on it.
Not this time. Well, okay. So let's just leave her there.
Yeah,
actually,
she'll be
wait a
fine,
second.
I'm
we
sure.
got bolt cutters.
Oh, yeah. I don't know
let's
why I didn't
bolts.
Think of that.
Nothing happened. Well, sorry. Good
oh.
idea.
Well, we tried. See you later.
Sorry, lady. You gotta stay there. I'll rescue you again.
Should we serenade her with our flute?
No.
There is an old beach house here which looks as though it may be haunted as you notice the strange shadows and sounds from inside.
Yeah, that means it's haunted.
Uh-oh.
Let's open the door from all the way over here. We just did it. That's awesome. Going inside.
Do it.
Oh, my word. Mm.
Oh, whoa, okay. Located in the entrance hall, a grand staircase winds up into the unknown, and a ghost-like creature is floating throughout the room. That's floating.
Yeah, no kidding. Let's just look at it. Hi. Ah,
hello.
Crap.
Fool! It's the same ghost
it's the same
from
one.
Earlier.
Yeah. Let's see. So I guess we don't go in the house yet. Or we do, we just need something.
Is there anything that we can take on any of these screens? There must be something.
I haven't noticed anything. I mean, you know, there's... got palm trees. I took a coconut. Well, what do you know?
You took a coconut?
I just took a coconut. I was going to make a joke about grabbing something with, you know, relating to nuts, and, well, it happened, so we got an average coconut here.
Well, there you go.
It's an average coconut, though. I want an excellent coconut. Where are those?
No, we gotta be cool with the mediocre coconuts, I'm afraid.
I know there are better nuts out there, though, and that's the problem. Whatever.
Oh, my.
Let's go in the house. Because, yeah. Maybe the ghost thing is just hungry. Give him some coconuts.
Did we try to unlock the girl from her shackles?
Oh, yeah. Well, no, we already used the key on our door. I mean, what's...
Maybe it's a skeleton key.
Yeah, maybe. Let's just walk past that ghost. Screw that ghost. We're upstairs now.
The hall contains two doors and a window up ahead, providing a view of the back of the house. The floorboards and walls are covered with dust, and there is a strange musty smell coming from one of the other rooms. Ooh, must.
Dang. The last one you got eerie ambience, and you got must all over the place here, so.
That's cool.
It's good stuff. Opening that door. Opening that door. Let's go in one of them. Gonna go to the left. There's a thing.
This room is quite scary looking, with its walls covered with spiderwebs and dust. There is both a bed and dresser here with odd-looking paintings on the walls.
Huh.
So, I assume we can take that purple thing, whatever that is. Oh, rum!
Bottle of rum! Yeah, we gonna get drunk. I hope so. We got blackjack, we got
booze.
Drinking. This is much better. Alright. So, we got that. Can we use it? Nope. Oh, we can open it.
We could give it to the girl.
Save it. Yeah, here's something to just, you know, take a little bit of the sting of being chopped up, or not chopped up, locked up up against a volcano.
Here's what we do, right? We give her the booze, get her loosened up a bit, and then give her the ring. And she'll say yes, and then we're not a bachelor anymore.
It's possible.
Yeah.
I had just hit open on the bottle of rum, and then the coconut split in half. I swear that just happened.
I don't know. Yeah, we could give the rum to the pirate.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Let's do that. Actually, let's see if we can open these drawers or something. See if Teddy pops out.
It's not polite. You're snooping. Terrible.
When has that stopped anything before?
We just took somebody's rum.
We took their friggin' liquor, and we're totally doing things earlier. What in the world? Whatever. What a weird game.
I miss Teddy.
I know. I hope he shows up again.
I do too.
Here, we got another alternative here, though.
That's
so.
Not Teddy. This place looks as though it's at least a few hundred years old. There is a king-size bed with who knows what underneath, and a large shelf-like dresser beside it.
Good stuff. Who knows what underneath? Yeah, couldn't be a skeleton that's moving or anything. Who knows what that
having
is?
Having a seizure.
Somebody had an idea for using the coconuts as cups or something, which that's possible.
Like for the rum?
Yeah, I guess. That's a good idea. Just drink it from the bottle. I don't know. Anyway, let's just look around in here. Oh, there's a breeze. Slight breeze. That's good. Contains nothing on a shelf. Strange picture. Strange ghost. Huh.
A lot of strange things going on here.
It says, a strange ghost located beneath the bed. Nothing too different.
Nothing out of the ordinary here. Carry on.
This is
carry
weird
on.
Crap as always. You know, it's just like that. Okay, well, I guess we can't do anything to that ghost. So, I mean, we could talk to it. I guess not. Well, let's try the rum on the pirate. That's a good idea.
Yeah, let's do it.
I mean, there's another room down here, though.
No.
Hey, look!
Oh, hello. This must be the kitchen with its old-fashioned decor and appliances, such as the refrigerator probably not plugged in and still containing food. There is also the unusual smell coming from a lady standing in front of the sink with her back towards you.
You stank, woman! What is wrong?
It smells like must.
Must?
Perhaps we could give her
some... Oh, I shouldn't have done that.
Ooh, should not have done that one. Nope.
I examined her.
Hello.
Doesn't want to be examined.
I thought all ladies wanted to be examined.
Not this one. No, she has no face. That's a problem.
Let's give her the coconuts. That's good for your skin. You know, coconut milk. Could help.
Here you go. Nope.
Tomas,
get me out of here. If that'll work. Open a fridge. Wow, she doesn't care. Let's just open the fridge. Let's look in there. Oh,
nope,
she cares.
She cares. That is her fridge, sir. The lady seems unamused by uninvited dinner guests. You try to run, but your efforts are useless as she begins to stab your chest.
Well, that's a problem. All right. I guess we'll just leave the lady alone.
Oh.
Well, I mean, we can try again, but I don't know what else to do to her.
No, I definitely think we should go give the rum to the pirate. I imagine that's likely what he wants.
I would. I mean, piracy.
Or we could, like, pour the rum into the coconut or something. Can make, like, a piña colada makeshift.
It's possible. Okay, pirate. What's this? Aha. Yeah, well... So,
left my rum prepared in a tropical way. Arr.
That would be in a coconut, so here you go. I'll try to put it in there. Let's try that.
Do we have a little umbrella that we can put in there?
We got an umbrella and a straw in it now.
Oh, look at that. That's adorable. The pirate takes the mixed drink and prepares to shove off.
Wait, what?
You've escaped!
What does that mean?
We won.
That can't be the end.
But we...
Or have you? Oh, there was something creepy there. It was a... Oh, it's haunting you. Oh, that's weird. Yeah, Aunt's face is showing up and...
Uh-ohs.
And doing weirdness. You see that?
No.
It's flashing quickly.
So, I think we didn't win.
I'm not sure what to do.
Well, that woman is still attached to the volcano. So there's...
It just quit, though. We must have not, like, done anything right. Because it's not working. Like, it's like, okay, you got away from wherever it was, but yet nothing was resolved and your aunt's still creeping you out. So I'm assuming that's probably like a not so good ending, and then we maybe have to get a better one.
Yeah. I think we should probably go back and do something with the woman on the volcano.
Yeah, man, we should totally be rescuing her at least.
Here's something that would be interesting. What if that woman is your aunt in her younger years and we're saving her?
Ooh, Tomas.
I don't know. Tomas! I have no idea. That's probably not correct at all. Go back to the woman on the volcano, Plox.
Okay. There we is.
I am dead certain we have to unshackle her. So operate the bolt on the girl.
Yeah. We tried that. Let's try the key. We didn't try the key last time. Nope.
I'm certain.
Nope. Well, yeah, I mean, the bolt cutters, we gotta be using them for something. I guess it's just not her. Huh.
Can we...
At least not yet.
We can't speak to her. We can't...
I don't think so. Nah, unnoticed. I guess she's too busy shaking. Well, there's other places to go. I mean, we still haven't gone down here to the right. And a ghost pirate.
Weird. He's covered in spaghetti sauce.
Moss guy and spaghetti guy.
What are we going to do with this guy?
I don't know.
Give him some rum. No, don't. Okay, don't give him rum. Can we just...
The other guy needs it.
Can we distract him with the flute?
Nope. Try the fire. That doesn't work. Bolt cutters. That don't work. How about a ring? Nope. He does not have any interest in matrimony. Well, now what then? We can try to hit him. Probably will end well. Nope.
Give him the map so you can see if he can print it out for us.
He at least did respond to what I said.
It's true.
Said no time to kill me. Okay. Well, what the crap?
I don't know. We must be missing something. I just don't know what we're missing.
Yeah. Okay, so there was nothing in this room but a creepy ghost under the bed. So we got the creepy ghost downstairs, weird lady in the kitchen, ghost under the bed. I mean, I don't know what half of these things even could possibly do, but...
Let's go back to the woman in the kitchen. Maybe she can do something. Okay.
So she's there.
So, what have we used on her before?
Nothing, because she turns around and stabs you.
But that's because you opened the fridge.
Well, I think it happened if I did anything.
Really?
We can try using things on her.
Use the bolt cutters on her.
Nope.
Okay.
Nothing with the flute. Nothing with the torch.
Can we speak to her?
I think... I'm terrible at typing with one hand. Anyway, yeah, it's not happening. When I examined her, I think she turned around last time.
I'm not sure.
Examining her, she turns around when you examine her.
Well, now let's give her the bolt cutters.
Maybe. Here, have a bolt cutter. Nope. Watch me play the flute. Nope, that didn't work either.
Tropical drink?
I don't know.
Okay, walkthrough time?
Yeah, probably, okay. Because I am completely at a loss.
We've gotten this far without a walkthrough, and I think that's insanely impressive. So let me look.
We have done pretty
good.
Let me look
and see what this says. Okay. From the screen with the sign, go left, then right. By the volcano, there is a palm with coconuts. Take one, open it. Operate the bolt cutters on the little girl in your inventory and operate or throw her into the volcano. Don't worry, she was a decoy made to fool you. The girl on the rack is the real thing. Take her.
Wait, what? Operate the what?
I'm not kidding. That is what it says.
Who wrote this, man?
It's like the only walkthrough I could find.
Okay. So what did it say to do? Use bolt cutters on something?
It says, and I thought I told you to do this and it didn't, but it says,
yeah.
Operate the bolt cutters on the little girl in your inventory and throw her.
I don't have a little girl in my inventory. So I'm like, what?
Do I have
like Thumbelina in here? Is she just chilling in my pocket? Why is she there? I don't like that. I think
that's poorly written. Yeah, you're supposed to operate the bolt cutters on her.
And I am. Clicking bolt cutters. Clicking whatever. I click her. I'm clicking the locks or whatever.
Go back to the screen with the sign. Go right and enter the house. Go up the stairs. Enter the door to the left and take the bottle, which is the rum. Leave the house. Go back to the screen with the sign. Open the bottle. The only thing we have left to do is operate the bolt cutters on the little girl and throw her into the volcano, and that's it.
Well, then we've effectively gotten through it.
Unless there's something that we've missed, unless there's a screen that we missed.
What was that about the rack? There was a rack?
Yes.
Where? I haven't seen a girl on a rack. Was that the first game? Is it talking about the first game?
I don't know. What did you do?
I'm just talking to people, you know.
I checked further back in this walkthrough. I mean, it says, you know, you find yourself on Ghost Island. So that's the last sentence. You find yourself on Ghost Island. This is right when we get there. From there, it says, from the screen with the sign, go left, then right.
Did that.
By the volcano, there's a palm with coconuts. Take one, open it. Operate the bolt cutters on the little girl in your inventory and throw her into the volcano.
I can't use the bolt cutters. Maybe there's like open bolt cutters. Close bolt cutters. Nope, doesn't do crap. This is so stupid. Operate. What is wrong? It's so close. I can feel it.
Okay, I'm gonna let me go even further back in the walkthrough and see if we missed anything.
Let me email William and be like, dude, your game is broken from 21 years
borked.
ago.
Let's see here. I don't think we actually missed anything. The reason you've been going through the dungeon is because of the caretaker's dog who dwells in the passage maze. You will meet him several times before finding your way out. The only way to save yourself from him is to operate the torch on him. Huh. Sounds familiar. Only downside is that the torch will go out and you'll have to navigate in darkness back to a doorway. When you leave the doorway, go right, keep going. Use the red key on the door, open it and leave. You meet the gypsy. She gives you instructions. She tells you about the word Tamaz. Take the bolt cutters on the shelf. Go up the ladder. Enter the attic.
Oh, no. What did I do?
What?
I tried to take the girl.
Oh, shit.
Well, that's something.
It would appear the volcano is not pleased with their efforts to take its virgin away from the area. Fire and lava begin to shoot into the sky, as well as large boulders, one of which seems to fly toward your head, killing you instantly. You know, I look away for 2 seconds, Clint.
And I set off an entire cataclysmic event. Oh, that's just terrible. Well, that's apparently not what we do.
All right, I'm
don't
Clint. I'm gonna go back to looking at the walkthrough. Can I trust you with the game for like 5 seconds?
For the moment, sure. I'm going to continue screwing around.
Okay. Let's see here. It says one last thing. There are bugs in this game, so save often.
Yeah, no kidding.
But that's what the walkthrough says. So I don't know. I don't know what we could possibly do. It says operate the bolt on the girl, and push her into the volcano.
I have done this.
Okay, let me look.
So many. Okay, look, last resort. I am going to try another version of this game. I have another one. It's the EGA version. So.
Do you remember the room with the dog eyes? With the blinking seizure eyes?
Yeah.
We never really did anything.
There was nothing in there. You had what's his name? Teddy. That was it.
If you examine the eyes, you'll find that it is a chained girl that is looking back at you. Wow. But why would that make any difference?
I don't know.
Why would that? Please tell me why that would make any difference or any bearing on the game that we would have to do that. I want to know why.
It shouldn't. Whatsoever. That makes... Of course, not much else makes much sense in here anyway. And as seeing as buggy as some of the other things have been so far... Maybe it just doesn't like anything about humans, and it just wants to destroy everything.
Like, even if we missed that, who cares? Like, we got to Ghost Island. We're at the volcano. We have the bolt cutters. That's just how it was programmed. You got to find things before you can do other things.
I guess. This might be the same version. I thought it was a different version, okay. But...
Well, say Tamaz. Speak Tamaz.
Okay, it brought us back here.
We gotta get back. We gotta get back to the dungeon.
Alright, yeah, we're back. Okay, so I'm in the dungeon. Where are we going?
To that room with the blinking eyes.
Blinking eyes. That's down
here. We actually do have to take a girl and put her in our inventory. I kid you not.
A girl in the inventory. That's amazing. Yes.
Okay.
So we examine the eyes. Yeah, and we did that. And it says, do you have the feeling
Say
you're
yes.
being watched? It's the same thing as earlier.
I don't know if that's it. Hang on. I could have sworn that's what that walkthrough said, was to examine the eyes. Examining the eyes, you'll find that it is a chained girl and it's looking back at her. Just try to take the eyes. I don't know.
Can't take eyes.
Good lord.
Like, because you go in there and there's nothing, and a pair of eyes, examining the eyes, freaking examine the crap out of these eyes.
Wrong
they haven't done
room?
Anything.
They're saying it's the wrong room.
Well, in what other room?
You want the hall with the screaming.
The screaming. You know, there's a lot of screaming in this game. It would help if it were more specific.
Okay, so when you get to that, remember when, obviously I can't hear the sound on my end, but when you get to that hall with the screaming, you're going to hit it. You're going to hit the wall.
What?
The one where somebody's calling for help, remember? Kind of? I kind of remember what it looks like. Yes.
This one?
Hit the wall.
Like, hit?
Okay.
Oh, whoa, okay.
Examine those eyes.
Wow. There's a chained little girl in there.
Take
now
her.
What? Oh, man. Oh, I got a girl in my pocket.
What?
I am so confused. Okay, well, that's fine.
Oh, sure. That was a really intuitive puzzle. I'm sure everybody knew to do that.
My goodness. What? Who?
All right, speak to Maz.
To Maz. Okay. Can't believe that works. Okay,
okay.
Now we use the friggin' bolt cutters on her, what, on her?
I think so. You might want to save
pocket.
Your game.
She's in my pocket. Oh, yeah, that's right. I should
before
probably
we do
that.
Anything.
Bolt cutter. There you are. Oh, she's out of there. Good. Now
okay.
What?
Okay. Throw her into the volcano. I'm not kidding.
Yeah. Operate. What did we use her?
Throw her in there.
Yay! Well. Burn!
Okay.
Oh, now we can probably just take her because the volcano's okay. There we go.
This path leads... Oh, it's the same thing.
Okay, look, so we got lady, another one in our pocket.
Okay.
It's a girl! Yay, congratulations.
This is messed up. This is messed up.
Amazing.
We found a little girl in the wall who wanted help. We threw her in the volcano, and then we took this one.
So... Do we give the pirates the rum and leave
yes.
now? Okay. Here's the mixed drink, sir. Cool. I have escaped again! And something else may happen.
I think we won.
I don't think it changes the ending whatsoever, though.
Oh, it doesn't?
Not yet. It's the same ending so far.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it's the same friggin' ending.
Oh.
There's got to be something else at the end.
Maybe we actually just did win. I mean, there is...
Oh, you have made me proud. Thank you.
Oh,
hey, look.
Oh,
yay.
Look how proud she looks.
She's smiling.
That's a smile.
Yeah. We get an ending.
Congratulations.
Screen.
It looks as though you've made it out of this horrifying nightmare as you sail away into the darkness of a creepy old ghost ship. Looking back, you have an eerie feeling that you are being watched. A faint shadow-like figure can barely be seen on shore, which appears to be standing next to a cannon while looking through an eyeglass and shouting, "Ye pirates, never leave me island!" A loud cannon is heard from the shore. What?
That cracks me up, man. Oh, there's a figure back on the shore which appears to be standing next to a cannon while looking through an eyeglass and shouting. A battle begins. Oh,
there
no.
are so many plot holes that I don't understand.
A ghost ship begins to sink. You and the girl find a rowboat. You huff and puff.
What?
Yeah, it's going on. It's still going here.
Okay.
You're able to row to the base of a large rocky mountain, which contains a creepy-looking castle high above. Will you ever escape? Find out in Last of Darkness 3. Oh, we gotta find out at some point.
I have no idea what we're doing. What does this have to do with our aunt? Who is that woman? Who is the girl in the wall? Who is the girl in the wall?
I don't know. What was... And nothing of the first game had anything to do with this one, really.
No, they're very, very disconnected.
They're entirely different. I'm so confused.
I don't know what to say. I'm speechless for once. I liked it, though, still. I still liked it. I still thought it was charming. Definitely not as charming as the first one, but... charming nonetheless. Kind of glitchy, but probably an emulation problem.
Some of it, yeah. Like, I think with the blackjack area, that was probably DOSBox. But, like, there's some other stuff, too. It was so weird. And just... finding a girl in a wall and putting
her in her pants.
Other than that, we got it all.
Wouldn't you want a girl in your pants?
I am not at liberty to say.
It's a very classy answer. I'm impressed at how you handled that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Please leave that in the Let's Play.
Yeah, I've got to.
Oh, man. That was a fun time, though. I love it. Love these games. I really do.
It's enjoyable in its own bizarre way. This one is... it's just weird, but it's still cool. You know what we should do? We should go through all these, and apparently there is a remake of the first three games with some fixes and stuff.
Oh, really?
And they were redone in like a modern engine. So yeah, cool. we should totally go and go through the third one and then try the remake.
That would be totally awesome. I'm down for that. I like this game. I like this game a whole lot. I don't know why.
Yeah, man.
I don't know why. Obviously, I was frustrated with the walkthrough stuff and the other stuff, but still.
Our walkthrough made no sense. The girl in your inventory.
I just wasn't looking back far enough to understand what I thought that was just a grammatical error in the walkthrough.
Well, there's like, so many okay. in the game too. You get in the mindset of trying to decipher just basic English when playing the game. So yeah, I can. Oh man.
Well, should we end the stream here?
I suppose so. I think that's enough for one night because I can't deal with any other little girls in my pants at the moment. That's just too much.
I can't either. That is a lot. That's a lot to handle. I understand completely. Still, I had a fun time. Thank you for having me. Thanks for playing this game with me.
Definitely, yeah.
I'm not sure if you would have ever discovered it if it weren't for me pointing it out.
No, probably not, but hey, we know now.
We know now, yes. Awesome. Well, guys, anybody who's still in the stream there, thanks for joining us.
Yes, thanks for tuning in, whoever is here.
And we'll let you know when we're streaming next. So I'll see you guys later.
Yes, bye all for now.